Welcome to the 2022 Excellence in Mentoring Awards. I'm George Daly. I'm the Dean of Harvard Medical School. And I have to say, it's great to be back together. But I think we all take incredible delight in re-engaging with the community. And I can't think of a better ceremony to have than this one. This is really one of my favorites of the year. I guess we are also having a number of folks joining by live stream as well. So I just want to welcome all of them and recognize that we're going to be celebrating this year's recipients of the Excellence in Mentoring Awards. So as I understand, this is the 27th year of honoring exceptional mentorship. And I have to say, over the years that I've presided, it has really been an extraordinary testimony to the contributions of our current mentorship award winners, but also I think about all of the past impact of all of our awardees. I am certain that, as similar for many of you, mentorship has always been an essential part of the benefits that I've enjoyed throughout my career. But it's also one of my greatest senses of satisfaction. Today's actually my lab day. I came over from my lab, and I'll tell you, there's just no greater pleasure than to witness the drive and the success of one's trainees. It's a tremendous feeling. But mentorship represents a commitment to the future through our investment in the people that we care about now. And I have to say that I believe that these awards are among the most important on one's CV. And I can tell you that I hear them called out frequently when we are doing promotion reviews and all, that someone won a mentorship award, and that really matters, because the benefits are broad. They're not just to the individual trainees whom you have mentored, but it's to the whole institutional culture. It really is what makes this place fabulous. So I will just quote from John Maxwell, who is an author, a speaker, a pastor. He once said, "One of the greatest values of mentors is the ability to see ahead what others cannot see and to help them navigate a course toward their destination." That's certainly one wonderful definition of mentorship. So I want to start just by thanking all of you, the mentors who will be recognized today, for walking beside and cheering on and giving selflessly, because this is really, we're a community that's so much about excellence and achievement. This is about service. It's about compassion and support of others. And so I just think it's a wonderful ceremony. And I want to congratulate all of you on a great honor. And I'm going to turn this over to Joan Reed, who's professor of medicine and our dean for diversity and community partnership. Joan, over to you.
Thank you, Dean Daly. The first Excellence in Mentoring Award was established in 1995 and was renamed in 1997 to honor the memory of Dr. A. Clifford Barger, who, among other things, devoted his career to bringing out the best to those of those that studied, trained, and worked at Harvard Medical School. The Lifetime Excellence in Mentoring Award was established in 1997 and in 2001 was renamed in honor of William Silen as the William Silen Lifetime Achievement in Mentoring Award. And the Young Mentoring Award was established in 2005 to recognize faculty who were a little earlier in their careers at Harvard Medical School, but still devoted the time and effort and energy toward mentoring. As been stated by our dean, mentoring benefits not only the mentee, it benefits the mentor, it benefits the institution, it benefits us as a whole. And I want to thank each of you who give of yourself unselfishly and believe that mentoring is an important and meaningful part of our professional lives. Every year, We asked faculty, research, and clinical fellows and students at Harvard Medical School and Harvard School of Dental Medicine to identify a mentor who's provided sponsorship, encouragement, and support for their career, as well as for the career development of their colleagues. And I'm very pleased that over the past 27 years, we've celebrated more than 330 recipients among thousands. And I can tell you thousands of nominations. I've read them all. But we're going to start today's ceremony by acknowledging the recipients of the HMS Scholars in Medicine Excellence in Student Mentoring Award that was established by the HMS Scholars in Medicine Office. Prior to graduation, all medical students are required to carry out a scholarly project with the guidance of a faculty member. And this award was established to recognize the value of quality mentoring relationships and the impact they have on student research and professional development. Graduating students are invited to nominate their mentors and describe how the faculty member's mentoring has affected their progress as a medical student. It's my pleasure to introduce the recipients of the HMS Scholars in Medicine Excellence in Student Mentoring Award. The recipients are joining us by Zoom, and on the next slides, you'll see an image of the recipient as well as a quote from the mentees. And our first recipient is Dr. Rebecca Hartman. She's an assistant professor of dermatology at Brigham and Women's Hospital. And congratulations, Dr. Hartman. The second recipient is Dr. Gazir Ortega. Dr. Ortega is an instructor in surgery at Brigham and Women's Hospital. Congratulations, Dr. Ortega. And our final recipient is Dr. Catherine Wu. Dr. Wu is a professor of medicine at Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. Congratulations, Dr. Wu. To all of the nominees and the recipients of the 2022 HMS Scholars in Medicine Excellence in Student Mentoring Award, congratulations to all. We're now going to turn to the 2022 Excellence in Mentoring Awards. This year, we received 368 nominations for 145 individuals. A list of nominees is found in the program book, and the Office for Diversity and Inclusion and Community Partnership, DICP, website. You can also find a list of the names of all of the nominees. An advisory committee with representatives from across our HMS community and HSDM community carefully reviewed and discussed the nominations and recommended this year's recipients. And it's my pleasure to introduce and begin with the recipients of the 2022 Young Mentor Award. After I've shared a quote from the nominations, I'll ask each of the recipients to come to the podium to receive your award and have a photograph taken with the dean and share your brief remarks. And I'm gonna say, as I say your name and start reading the quote, start coming forward. Although you'd like to have that long walk down the aisle, start coming forward as I say your name. Okay. The first recipient of the Young Mentor Award is Dr. Izzedine Aris. Dr. Aris is an assistant professor of medicine at Massachusetts General Hospital. Dr. Aris provides me with excellent scientific guidance, which allows me to successfully achieve important career development goals under his mentorship, and which have resulted in publications in high-impact journals and invited talks at national conferences. I continue to be in awe of his intelligence, productivity, and just generosity of time, effort, and knowledge. He is humble and has a quiet brilliance. Despite his youth and being a junior faculty, he has a maturity and wisdom beyond his age and position. Dr. Aris, please join me at the podium.
For the kind words, Dr. Reed. I'd have to say it was a really nice surprise to have received your call a couple of months ago for the good news. Thank you for making this a major highlight of my year. And I'm humbled to receive this award and grateful to my mentees, who I really view as my collaborators, actually, for nominating me for this award, for trusting in my mentorship, and also for providing me the opportunity to share my knowledge and also to learn from them. I'm fortunate and blessed to be working with wonderful mentors in my department, Emily Oaken, Jason Block, Marie-France Hivert, Richard Platt, just to name a few, who are instrumental in making the department or laying the groundwork to build a department with strong mentorship and also from whom I have learned. My heartfelt thanks to those closest to me who unfortunately couldn't be here, but they are watching virtually. My family who's watching from Singapore, which is has a 12-hour time difference. So it's like 4 a.m. right now. So thank you. And also my partner watching all the way from the West Coast. So thank you again for this honor.
Thank you, Ms. Dean, and congratulations. The next recipient of the Young Mentor Award is Dr. Kimberly Blumenthal, Harvard Medical School Assistant Professor of Medicine at Massachusetts General Hospital. Quote, the greatest career hurdle is knowing where you want to be, but not knowing how to get there. When I expressed my interest in quality and safety on the fellowship interview trail, most people gave me a metaphorical pat on the head and asked what I really wanted to do. Dr. Kimberly Blumenthal validated my passions as implementation science and not only encouraged me in pursuing my dream, but also showed me how to do so. Dr. Blumenthal, please join us at the podium.
Thank you so much for having these awards, and thank you, Harvard Medical School. I'm an allergist and researcher, and when I was first interested in learning about how to do epidemiology research and simulation research methods, I knew that no one in my division had any expertise in this. I was also drawn to a clinical topic that no one had ever had extramural research funding for. These factors made it difficult for me to find mentorship. I was so fortunate to find an infectious disease doctor who was interested enough in antibiotic allergy, who agreed to take me on as a research mentee. That ID doctor was Rochelle Walensky, and she was my research mentor for over 7 years before she left to be a CDC director. She's also a recipient of the Young Mentor Award and the Barger Award. I'm so grateful for her mentorship and also from the sponsorship and clinical mentorship that I received from Alina Banerjee, who's an expert in drug allergy, who helped me really become the mentor I am today. I followed Rochelle's lead, and now I mentor others regardless of their topic or methods expertise, even when it's different from my own. Asthma, telemedicine, process improvement, it's more challenging to do so, but wow, how rewarding it is to see your mentees find their own footing, carve their own unique space. Thank you to all of my mentees for this nomination and award today. I'd also like to thank my family, who has supported my career in academic medicine. Thanks to my father, who believes I could do anything, which is just the greatest thing in the world. My husband, Dan, who actually helped me find my passion in medicine and research. And to our three boys, 10, 7, and 5, they decided to join by Zoom like many of you today. They thought that they could still do their after-school activities and that I would still bring them back the best snacks. My sons are my biggest fans, my biggest loves. And they cheer me on every day and every week so that I can mentor with enthusiasm. Thanks.
Congratulations, Kimberly. Dr. Vicky Fung is our third recipient of the Young Mentor Award. Dr. Fung is an associate professor of medicine at Massachusetts General Hospital. A mentee of Dr. Fung's wrote, she also went beyond what was required of her on her paper to make sure we were heading where we wanted to be both professionally and personally. For me, she exemplified the importance of speaking up with the diverse perspectives we have as women of color. I often struggled with confidence in expressing my research ideas or questions. She reminded me as gently and frequently as I needed to not apologize or downplay my contributions and to prioritize getting the experiences I needed to grow. She thought deeply about her role in all of our development beyond the lab's to-dos. Dr. Fung, please join me at the podium.
Thank you, Dr. Reed, Dr. Daly, and to Harvard Medical School for this really incredibly unexpected but truly meaningful award. It's such a joy to see some of my mentees in person today. It's how exciting is that? And I heard that a number more are on Zoom. And so I just really want to thank you all for taking the time to nominate me, taking time out of your very busy schedules to write letters of support. It's truly been the best part of my job to have the opportunity to collaborate with you and to teach you and to learn from you. You all really inspire me continually with your own professional and personal achievements. And so thank you. And of course, thanks to all of my mentors who taught me so much about what it means to mentor others. One of my longest mentors, John Hsu, really taught me kind of what it means to give mentees and trust them with real opportunities for professional growth. And that has really informed the way that I mentor. Of course, to my family for putting up with, you know, Slack messages at the dinner table, and my husband who grills at the summer picnic and, you know, supports me in so many immeasurable ways. My parents, who are also academics, who showed me that my dad's students were always part of our extended family. And I hope that I can continue that tradition. Know that you are part of my extended family. You cannot be rid of me. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Vicki. Dr. Catherine Gray is our next recipient of the Young Mentor Award. Dr. Gray is an assistant professor of obstetrics, gynecology, and reproductive biology at Brigham and Women's Hospital. And a mentee shared this quote. Dr. Gray has been absolutely instrumental in my development as an aspiring physician. As I started my co-op, nervous second-year college student, she allowed me to feel comfortable stepping into my role as an undergraduate research co-op. She gave me the same respect she gives her fellow physicians, and seeing this boosted my confidence immensely. Dr. Gray is and has always been incredibly approachable as well. I was never nervous to ask her a question or admit when I thought I had done something wrong. As she approaches any problem a person on her team encounters as a problem that we face together, I know that I have a mentor for life in Dr. Gray. Dr. Gray, please join me at the podium.
Thank you so much for this award. It was really the best part of my day when I got that phone call. I've learned so much from my mentees over the year, and I thank all of them for taking the time to write the letters of support. I learned just as much from them as anyone else, and it's really been a privilege for everyone that I have worked with here. I benefited in my career here and previously from many excellent mentors, but Risha Saxena, who's here in the audience today from MGH, has been my mentor for the 11 years I've been here, and I really attribute a lot of the qualities I've gained in mentoring my own mentees from her kind, patient, and very insightful way of mentoring me, and I am immensely grateful for that. I'm also super grateful to my parents, who my mom was the one who said, you know, you can do anything. She was started the recycling program in our hometown, and she was the first woman to be on our city council in my hometown. And because of that, I believed that I could do whatever I wanted to do. I thank my parents, who are taking care of my three boys right now, who are also my cheerleaders, who are almost 11, 7, and 4. And I think they're doing their after-school activities and they're not watching Zoom. thank you so much. And I would say one of the best things I've heard in the past 2 weeks is the quote, like, people who want to see you win, will help you win. And I like thinking about that and being the person who will help others win and surrounding myself with people who want me to win. Thank you to everybody.
Congratulations, Catherine. Dr. Rory Jackson is our fifth recipient of the Young Mentor Award. Dr. Jackson is assistant professor of immunology at Harvard Medical School. Quote, Dr. Jackson is not just an excellent scientist, albeit being the most humble person at Harvard, but he is foremost an outstanding mentor. I had the privilege to assist him in building his current lab, and I recall discussions with him when he talked about how important building a good lab atmosphere was for him. He wanted to create a space where his trainees enjoyed coming to work, a place where we would all feel inspired to give our best and grow as scientists and feel free to voice our own ideas, a place without any form of discrimination, but filled with freedom of scientific expression. Dr. Jackson, please join me.
Hi, so I just want to really thank my lab for coming and having signs and stuff. So it was really surprising when I found out when you called me and I got this award. I wasn't expecting it. It was very touching. But I feel like this mentoring has been with me since I was a child. My parents were excellent mentors, got me through the equivalent of high school in Ireland, which was not always looking great, points-wise, to do science. And then I did my PhD, and I had excellent mentors there, and they really helped me, you know, get my degree. And then when I moved to America to do my postdoc, again, I was fortunate enough to have an amazing mentor. So when I started my lab, you know, and recruited in spring of 2020, I was hoping I could bring a lab that would be fun, socially inclusive, we could all get together. Pandemic happened, but we actually managed to do a really good job, I think. And now that we're back in person, you know, I think the greatest accomplishment of the lab is it's not my mentoring, but it's looking at my mentees mentoring other people in the lab. And I'm always inspired by that. So thank you, everyone. I really appreciate this award.
Congratulations, Rory. Dr. Eugene Richardson is our next recipient of the Young Mentor Award. Dr. Richardson is an assistant professor of global health and social medicine at Harvard Medical School. Quote, we met when Dr. Richardson delivered a guest lecture in what was then SW25, Case Studies in Global Health. He emphasized to the undergraduate class that he was available to help students interested in global health equity, and I took him up on his offer. Our meeting lasted several hours, and Dr. Richardson was keen to get to know me as a person, understand my beliefs, and offer me thorough guidance. Most importantly, he made clear that he was willing to support me throughout my undergraduate journey and beyond. He was to become one of the most influential and helpful mentors I've had. Dr. Richardson, please join me at the podium.
Thanks so much, Dean Reed, Dean Daly. I'd like to thank the students and fellows who nominated me and the senior faculty in the Department of Global Health and Social Medicine, including Byron and Mary Jo Good, who are here today, Solomon Kachavji, Megan Murray, Arthur Kleinman, Alan Brandt. But most of all, I'd like to dedicate this to our good friend, and dear mentor, Paul Farmer, who we lost earlier this year, but still inspires everything we do.
Congratulations, Eugene. Our next recipient of the Young Mentor Award is Dr. Zuri Song. Dr. Song is an associate professor of healthcare policy and medicine at Harvard Medical School and Massachusetts General Hospital. A mentee of Dr. Song wrote, having Professor Zuri Song as an advisor during my PhD training was nothing short of transformational. Zuri cultivated an endless supply of patience, kindness, and wisdom, which were indispensable throughout my degree. Zuri continued to move my ideas and aspirations forward. I could not wish for a better mentor and friend. PhDs can be tough and isolating, but Zuri always ensured that I persevered. When I applied for faculty positions, Zuri wrote in to every single search committee chair on my behalf. This type of commitment is remarkable, and I remain incredibly grateful to him. Dr. Song, please join me at the podium.
Thank you so much, Dean Reed and Dean Daly, for this incredible honor. It really means a lot. I want to congratulate all of our colleagues here for their well-deserved recognition. For my colleagues, whom in the context of today are referred to as mentees, I want to thank you for bringing meaning and joy to the work that we do together. Watching you succeed and thrive is one of the most gratifying aspects of this work. I do not think of you as my mentees. You are my colleagues, and you have shown me the way just as much, if not more. I want to thank my senior colleagues in the Department of Healthcare Policy here, among them Nancy Keating, Barbara McNeil, Joseph Newhouse, Tom McGuire, Mike Chernu, and many others who have guided me for so many years. Lastly, I'd like to thank my wonderful, beloved wife, Dr. Catherine Koh here. Katie is a psychiatrist on the street team of Boston Healthcare for the Homeless and a beloved teacher of our introductory to psychiatry course here for our second year medical students. She's also the amazing mom of our two beautiful daughters. We are really talking about inspiring hearts, moving minds, or caring for people continuously, even as you're walking on the street, she should really be the one up here today. Thank you.
Congratulations. And our final recipient of the 2022 Young Mentor Award is Dr. Marinka Zitnik, who's an assistant professor of biomedical informatics at Harvard Medical School. Quote, while I am not a member of Marinka's lab, Marinka has nevertheless served as an incredible mentor and advocate for me throughout my PhD. I've been fortunate to collaborate with Marinka on two projects during which she has served as a role model for technical excellence, kindness, and selflessness. Marinka takes the time to meet with me weekly to give constructive feedback on my research and offer career advice. She provides insightful suggestions, and brainstorming with her is energizing and fun. When experiments do not go as planned, she is encouraging and supportive. Dr. Zitnik, please join us at the podium.
Thank you so much, Dean Reed and Dean Daly, for this award. This is a really incredible privilege that I feel to be here with all the prominent researchers and teachers and educators and mentors and to be among them. I'm incredibly thankful to my students, to my mentors and to my mentees at various different levels from undergraduate all the way to postdoctoral level. I've learned so much from them and was able to share my knowledge with them, and I see myself as a cheerleader who needs to find the energy and really support the students even when experiments fail and the algorithms don't work the way we expect them to work, and often together we find really the success by kind of discussing the projects and moving us forward. I have benefited incredibly throughout my career so far from mentors from various disciplines. As I work in research at the interface between artificial intelligence and biology, it's really important to then have an entire family of mentors who can provide the relevant knowledge from and expertise from a variety of different fields. And because of that, I see it in a way part of my duty to also be a mentor like that and support my students as well as students on the Quad who are interested in AI and machine learning and other techniques to kind of help facilitate this exciting areas and opportunities in the Quad. So I'm very thankful also to my department who has supported me through the last 3 years since I joined Harvard, particularly Zach Kohani and Suzanne Churchill from DBMI, and they continue to trust my research agenda and also the students that I help mentor. Thank you so much.
Congratulations, Marika. Can we get join me in congratulating all of our young mentors? It's my pleasure to present the A. Clifford Barger Excellence in Mentoring Awards. Dr. Barger devoted his career to bringing out the best in those who studied, trained, and worked at Harvard Medical School, believing that mentoring serves those who are mentored as well as those who mentor. Former mentees of Dr. Barger have been found at almost every medical school in the United States and many countries throughout the world, and they've emulated Dr. Barger's model of mentorship, and in return, they themselves have become excellent mentors. Again, after reading some words about the recipient, I'll ask their now presenter to come to the podium to introduce and present the award to their mentor, and then have the photograph taken together. And then the recipient will have an opportunity to say a few words. The first recipient of the 2022 A. Clifford Barger Excellence in Mentoring Award is Dr. Mark Awad, Assistant Professor of Medicine at Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. Dr. Awad is a humane and humble person who has helped countless people around him. In my pathway as an international medical graduate, I've never seen anyone approachable who cared about young physicians pursuing a career in the United States. I speak for me and a medical student from Puerto Rico who had the pleasure to spend some time on our team. She said marvelous things about Dr. Watt and how much he supported her in the residency application process. This speaks of his character and how he enables those around him to dream and grow. I hope someday to give back not only to him, but to my community and society in general. He's taught me so much more than oncology, opening my eyes to the responsibilities we have as people to become the best version of ourselves and always try to help others. Dr. Awad's award will be presented by Dr. Biagio, recruiting, research fellow in medicine at the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. Dr. Ricchetti, please come to the podium.
Thank you for inviting me today to present this award to Dr. Mark Awad. I have known Mark since 2018 when I joined the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute as a research fellow, and it's a pleasure to present this award today as an advanced clinical fellow in thoracic oncology as a testament of what he does every day and did for each of his fellows. Mark has been incredibly approachable. His door has always been open, and we have really treasured everything that he's taught us. We hope one day to inspire others as he inspires us on a daily basis. And so, without further ado, I am excited to present the Clifford Barger Award for Excellence in Mentoring to Dr. Awad.
Thank you so much, Dean Daly, Dean Reed. Thank you, Teresa, and the rest of the DICP office for arranging such a wonderful evening and event for tonight. Biagio, thank you for such kind remarks. They say a great mentor is somebody that sees more talent and ability in you than you see in yourself. It just helps bring it forth. And that's what I've had from my mentors, and that's what I hope to do with those that I'm mentoring. I'm very touched, as you might tell from my voice. It's such a special relationship between mentor and mentee. So I wanted to thank my mentees in the audience who are here. We have a 2-month old at home, so I'm a little sleep deprived. emotions, but I really wanted to thank everyone for this award. It's really quite special. I better wrap up before I get too tripped up here. I wanted to thank my husband, Adam, who's here in the audience, who's been a great support. The first thing he said when I received the Barger Award was he guessed I must have aged out of the Young Mentor Award. So always keeping me humble and on my toes. And I wanted to thank my parents who are in from St. Louis helping take care of our two-month-old here. But I really am very touched and honored. Thank you.
Congratulations, Mark. I love this about being sleep deprived. I remember calling on the phone. You're in that sort of state. I'm going to suggest, as I call the name of the awardee, as you start coming forward, maybe you, the person who's going to be presenting it could also come forward and take the picture while I'm speaking. All right. Here we go. Our next recipient is Dr. Terry Inder, formerly the Mary Ellen Avery Professor of Pediatrics, Newborn Medicine at Brigham and Women's Hospital. Dr. Inder recently moved to California and joins us via Zoom. She won't come forward for the picture. Aminti shared this quote. As a practicing neonatologist and a mother of young children, it often seems impossible to fit everything in. Terry has commiserated with me, but never let me give up. As an early and now mid-career researcher, the daily struggles of conducting research, writing manuscripts, and grant writing can be overwhelming. She's guided me towards areas to enhance my career development and away from other areas that might not be fruitful. She's encouraged and facilitated opportunities for me to gain visibility. She has encouraged me through research disappointments and helped me navigate challenging professional relationships. She does this by providing me with valued advice, but most importantly, by providing her example. In recognizing, validating, and appreciating these challenges, she's become an ally and co-warrior in forging my academic career.
Dr. Inder's award will be presented by Dr. Cece Lee, Associate Professor of Pediatrics at Brigham and Women's, and Dr. Rini Sen, Assistant Professor of Pediatrics at Boston Children's Hospitals. Drs. Lee and Sen, please come to the podium.
So we are honored to introduce Dr. Terry Inder on behalf of many mentees at both HMS and beyond. Terry epitomizes the virtues of a leader, a mentor, a sponsor, and a role model. Terry's unique talent is nurturing the leader in each of us. She guides her mentees to identify their strengths, their passions, and develop a career vision. She empowers us with the skills, connections, and resources to develop new clinical programs or areas of research. She encourages us to step outside of our comfort zone and to dream big. She fosters our capacity to reach our true potential. Finally, she's our strongest sponsor, advocating for her mentees to receive recognition and leadership positions.
Terry has always led by example, and it is her model of a physician, researcher, colleague, leader, friend, and mother that will help guide us as we move through our careers and our lives. She has listened, navigated, and encouraged us all through personal and professional challenges. She has delivered meals and provided unwavering support in times of crisis. In recognizing and appreciating our unique strengths, working with us to overcome challenges, and then celebrating our successes, she has become an ally and a co-warrior in forging countless careers in academic medicine. It is our great honor and joy to celebrate Dr. Inder today as she receives the Clifford Barger Mentoring Award.
Well, thank you so much for this most meaningful of any award that I've ever received. The letters from the mentees will be treasured for life. I often talk of three domains in my life: purpose or passion, people, and pride. Today, thanks to you mentees, you've brought these three words together. I don't have a two-month-old at home, but I'm probably going to cry. The chance that you gave me to live my passion of mentoring with people that I care enormously about and whom I'm so proud of, within an environment at Harvard that I am so grateful celebrates mentoring. And today you bring me pride. As one of my role models, Eleanor Roosevelt, said, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Dream big, stay positive, work hard, and enjoy this tremendous journey with eternal gratitude. And I apologize for not being there in person to be present to truly show the degree of gratitude, appreciation for this tremendous honor. Thank you, truly.
Congratulations, Terry. The next recipient of the Barger Award is Dr. Elizabeth Lawson, Associate Professor of Medicine at Massachusetts General Hospital. And this is going to be interesting. This is part of this move forward. Thank you. Coming from a background with minimal exposure to academic medicine, Dr. Lawson has truly changed my career's trajectory by giving me invaluable training and encouragement to pursue my dreams. I've gained an incredible amount of knowledge from her, and in addition to all the practical skills I've learned from her, I've greatly appreciated having her as a friend and confidant. She has also mentored incredible researchers and clinicians further in their careers than me, and seeing the great success they are able to achieve with her help is truly inspiring. They, in turn, have also been great mentors for me, and it's created a strong network of truly incredible and helpful individuals, where we can all draw upon each other's strengths and support each other. Dr. Lawson's award will be presented by Dr. Francesca Galbiati, Clinical Research Fellow in Endocrinology at Brigham and Women's Hospital.
Thank you, and it's an honor to be here today to speak on behalf of the whole Dr. Elizabeth Lawson's research team and introduce her to this award. Dr. Elizabeth Lawson is an associate professor of medicine at Harvard Medical School and a neuroendocrinologist at Massachusetts General Hospital. She's internationally well recognized for her important research contributions to the field of oxytocin. Over the years, she has been an extraordinary mentor to many, coming from different disciplines and at different career stages. She has wholeheartedly supported all of her mentees in achieving their life and career goals. And each of them has been extremely successful thanks to Dr. Lawson's dedication. Since early in my journey as a researcher, her wise advice has always been key. And she's inspirational when I think about my next steps. On behalf of the entire Dr. Lawson's team, I would like to express our gratitude for her guidance and the unique opportunity to learn from a role model. Congratulations.
Thank you, Francesca, for that really generous and beautiful introduction. I love my work and the time I spend with my incredibly talented mentees is the highlight of every day. I'd like to thank the selection committee for this great honor. My mentees who inspire me daily, particularly those who nominated me, Francesca Galbiati, Francisco Plesso, Leah Karam, Ana Alinas, Clara Saylor, Aluma Sella, Ethiopia Getachew, Majid Muhammad, Helen Murray, and Kendra Becker. My colleagues who provide amazing co-mentorship, particularly Cameron Eddy, Jenny Thomas, Madhu Misra, and Laura Holson. And of course, my own amazing mentors, Anne Klebanski and Karen Miller, who exemplify the kind of mentor I hope to be. I would also like to thank my family, my husband, Chapel, my husband Chapel, our sons Will and Patrick, who are here today, my brothers Carl, Jay, and Chris, and my parents Patty and Jerry Austin, for being my greatest source of joy, pride, inspiration, and support. My dad was an extraordinary mentor to many at Harvard Medical School and to me in my career and in my life. And for that, I am eternally grateful. Thank you very much again.
Thank you, Elizabeth. Our fourth recipient is Dr. Sarah Dolan-Luby, Assistant Professor of Medicine at Massachusetts General Hospital. Quote, of incredible value is the way in which Dr. Luby mentors me as a whole professional, integrating practical personal considerations while emphasizing the importance of self-care and work-life balance. Dr. Luby is the mentor who makes you macaroni and cheese and brownies and provides insight and guidance in your annual Boston apartment search and knows your family members' names and details about their lives, including dogs. As a nurse scientist with an independent program of research, Dr. Luby has served for me and many others as a model of career success. She's demonstrated the heights that a nurse scientist can achieve and charted pathways for others to develop a productive program of academic biomedical research and education. She integrates top quality professional success with a full life and enthusiasm that she carries into her work and our mentoring dynamic, contributing earnest enthusiasm, invaluable insight, and marked productivity. Dr. Luby's award will be presented by Dr. Markella Zani, Associate Professor of Medicine at Harvard Medical School, Director of the Women's Health Research Metabolism Unit at Massachusetts General Hospital. Dr. Zani.
It's an honor for me to introduce Dr. Sarah Luby as a 2022 recipient of the A. Clifford Barger Award. What makes Dr. Luby such an exemplary mentor? Three things. First, Dr. Luby sets an inspiring example for colleagues across disciplines as an accomplished nurse scientist who prioritizes patients' perspectives. Dr. Luby began her career as a registered nurse at MGH, caring for patients at their bedsides, and went on to acquire a PhD in nursing. She now leads an NIH-funded research program focused on healthy aging among women with HIV. Importantly, she shuns any personal glory associated with leading research. Instead, she focuses on ensuring that community members are engaged as partners in research and that research findings make their way back to the community. Second, Dr. Luby works tirelessly to enhance the HMS culture of mentoring on a systems level. She's a leader in the MGH Yvonne L. Munn Center for Nursing Research. She's played a major role in orchestrating the annual MGH Nursing Research Day celebration. She also founded and directs the Cannell Fellowship for Postdoctoral Study in Nursing Research. She brings to every initiative a can-do, glass-half-full, bounce-back attitude that guides towards positive outcomes. Third and finally, Dr. Luby shows up for her one-to-one mentees, putting their needs first, with a primary goal of seeing them succeed. She works nights, weekends, and holidays to share detailed feedback on writing, and she drops everything to listen and advise when mentees encounter challenges. Her mentee, Dr. Dickens R.E., describes her as truly a consummate mentor. Please join me in congratulating Dr. Luby, whose leadership and mentoring has had a major impact to enrich individual careers, the HMS institutional mentoring culture, and the communities of patients we've collectively committed to serve.
Thank you, Dr. Daly, Dr. Reed, and Markella. Thank you so much for your kind words and heartfelt introduction. And thank you to my mentees and colleagues in nursing and medicine at Mass General, who nominated me for this incredible award. Dr. Barger was a visionary who had the ability to recognize the best in people, and most importantly, to help them recognize the best in themselves, to achieve scientific accomplishments and foster their growth in heart and mind to truly make a difference. My sincere gratitude to the Barger family and HMS Awards Committee for sustaining his passion through this honor. I am humbled and fully committed to continuing his legacy through mentoring. To my mentees, past, present, and future, who are nurses, physicians, scientists, allied health professionals, and community members, all of you give me great hope for the future. Your passion, intelligence, innovative ideas, and energy, your work and motivation inspire me and so many others. Keep going. The world needs you. And it is a true honor for me to help shepherd you to your next amazing accomplishment. Lastly, thank you to my mentors who have led by example, professors, dear friends, colleagues in the community and MGH, especially Dr. Stephen Grinspoon, my dear friend and mentor for 21 years. Dr. Gordia Bannister, who's also here, an amazing leader at the Munn Center for Nursing Research at MGH. Dr. Inga Corliss, who got me started on this journey from the MGH IHP. And my family, my parents, Rosemary and Peter Dolan, the best mentors for 48 years. My siblings, Robbie and Amy, my husband, Greg, my son, Peter. Thank you all, and congratulations to all award nominees and recipients today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sarah. Our next recipient is Dr. Melissa Madison, Associate Professor of Medicine at Massachusetts General Hospital. And I quote, Melissa has played a significant role in optimizing collaborative team models, which aim to provide the best care to our patients, account for the changing capacity of inpatient medicine, and the complexity of our inpatient service lines. She believes we should never be afraid of trying new ideas. She's practical, actionable, and most importantly, present. Melissa wants to make sure that our team feels supported and is always looking out for the best of the group. I appreciate that Melissa values diversity and is a great advocate of the role of women in leadership. Because of her support, I was able to be selected as a palliative care scholar and participate in a hospital-wide initiative to increase serious illness conversations. She makes us feel well supported even when dealing with personal and professional obstacles. Dr. Madison's award will be presented by Dr. Amy Baugman, Assistant Professor of Medicine at Massachusetts General Hospital. Both Dr. Madison and Dr. Baugman are going to join us by Zoom. So Dean Daly,
this is going to be very interesting. I turn the program over now to Dr. Baugman.
Thank you. I'm delighted to introduce Dr. Melissa Madison, who is the chief of the Hospital Medicine Unit at MGH on behalf of my hospital's colleagues. She was recruited to MGH in 2014 and has led a miraculous turnaround story for our hospitalist group, growing the program from 30 physicians to a large, robust unit with over 150 physicians, physician assistants, and advanced nurse practitioners who care for up to 200 patients a day. Dr. Madison is an extraordinary hospitalist leader and role model. She has mentored me as well as countless other hospitalists on our professional and personal journeys, helping us advance our careers by creating or connecting us to leadership opportunities and providing counsel as we explore various paths. She has supported us as we grow our families, navigate tough decisions, and has worked tirelessly to continuously iterate the hospitalist role so that we can have rewarding and sustainable careers in hospital medicine. Congratulations to Dr. Madison for receiving this prestigious Clifford Barger Excellence in Mentoring Award.
Well, thank you, Amy. I hope you can all hear me. I apologize for not being there in person. I think as I've been listening and reflecting on what others have said, I think one of the commonalities here is having a supportive network supporting us as mentors, and family is a big part of that. And I'm at an important event for one of my kids tonight, so couldn't be with you all in person. But it is really my honor to be here, and I'm very grateful to have received this award. I want to, I don't have any pithy quotes or anything really overwhelming to say, other than I think a lot of the success that we all have is based upon the people who believed in us in the past. I've now been a member of the HMS community for nearly 25 years after joining BIDMC as an intern and then spending a dozen years there before moving across town to, or more than a dozen years there before moving across town to MGH. And all along the way, I think I was fortunate to work with some pretty incredible people as mentors. I just want to name a few of them: Jess Mandel, Mark Aronson, Bob Mollering, my co-chief residents who've all gone on to amazing things, Dimitri Daskalakis, who's tackling monkeypox for the country, Kristen O'Neill Callahan, who's a primary care doc on the North Shore, Mitha Goyle, who's a tremendous researcher in Chicago, and Alan Rep, who's an academic leader in Vermont. There are a number of folks in hospital medicine, both locally and nationally, who've played a tremendous role in my life, including Joe Lee and Angela Tess over at the BI, and Josh Metley at MGH. The chiefs of medicine who've supported me along the way, including Mark Seidel and Katrina Armstrong, are really unparalleled. And I think we just get strength from the folks that believed in us. And then lastly, and perhaps most importantly, is that I get the strength from my colleagues and peers that I get to work with every single day. And Amy and the rest of the folks who nominated me, I'm really grateful that you took the time to do that. And I'm also really proud of all the amazing work that you have done and that we've been able to do together as a team. So thank you all for this opportunity and for allowing me to say a few words. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Melissa. Our next recipient is Dr. Mara Schoenberg, Associate Professor of Medicine at Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center. Quote, as junior faculty, it's easy for me to feel that the demands of research and other competing demands make me unproductive or unsuccessful. Mara is always quick to highlight my accomplishments and reinforce my ideas as important and innovative. This type of active verbal support has helped me to develop a sense of personal identity and competence, which has been crucial to my success. Possibly most importantly is the sense of collegiality and trust that Mara creates in the mentoring relationship. She's generous with her time and materials and always an advocate for her mentees. She gives credit when credit is due and holds in confidence communication with mentees that is sensitive but required for good advising. Dr. Schoenberg's award will be presented by Dr. Gianna Aliberti, Clinical Fellow in Medicine at Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center. Dr. Aliberti, please come to the podium.
It's my absolute pleasure to introduce Mara, my mentor of over 7 years, for this award today. I met Mara back in 2015 as her research coordinator and have since navigated my entire professional career with her. She's expertly balances instruction with independence. She creates a learning environment that is based on mutual respect and just continuous questioning and learning. There's no question that's too small, no time too inconvenient, and no success not worth celebrating. More than 7 years after meeting Mara, she's still the first person I turn to, both professionally and personally. I wouldn't be where I am today without Mara's ever-present patience and support. There are none more deserving than Mara for recognition of excellence and mentorship, and I'm so honored to be here for her today.
Thank you so much. And thank you, Dr. Reed and Dr. Daly. This is a great opportunity. And thank you, Gianna, for that beautiful introduction. It has been one of the greatest joys of my career to watch Gianna move from coordinator to med student to now resident at Beth Israel, pursuing a career in health services research. I often tell my mentees that this is a really hard job. It's really hard to balance primary care medicine and all the demands and needs and staying up to date with health services research and all the demands and needs and grant writing and rejection and reapplying and and you know, and your own family and your own personal health and growth. And the only reason I could do it was my own mentors, as many have discussed. And ironically, I've been up here twice introducing amazing mentors, including Ed Marcantonio and Christina Wee, and Ellen McCarthy also received this award. And it's incredulous to me to be on this side of the award.
And I remember Ed saying when he came up here that this is one of the most meaningful awards we can get because it's one of the few we don't write our own letters. Yeah. And I'm not a tearjerker, and I'm actually almost near tears because it is so rewarding to be a mentor and awe-inspiring to see your mentees flourish in their careers in inconceivable ways, and you learn so much about their cultures and the way they interact and the way they communicate and the way they see the world, and it keeps you invigorated and wanting to do this work. And of course, it comes from even my childhood. My parents are here, Isla and Les, my best friend Amy Weinstein, my husband and my daughter, who's hopefully at her activities, are online. I couldn't do it without all of their support. And of course, I read about Clifford Barger, and he sounds like a mensch, and I'm honored to get this award. Thank you.
Thank you, Mara. Our final recipient of the Barger Award for Excellence in Mentoring is Dr. Anita Wagner, Associate Professor of Population Medicine at Harvard Pilgrim Healthcare Institute. Quote, I've been privileged to know Anita for over 20 years, having first met her when she was a doctoral candidate in pharmacoepidemiology. I've continued to serve as her mentor since she joined the HMS faculty, so I've had a bird's eye view of her development as a teacher and mentor. Anita has served as a formal mentor for over 30 fellows from 15 countries, including junior faculty, postdoctoral fellows, and predoctoral candidates. She is the rare individual who consistently, selflessly, and unpretentiously focuses on the needs of others. She brings this quality to her teaching and mentorship in a way that enables her students and mentees to feel listened to, valued, and motivated to achieve their best. She is enormously successful in helping mentees to make career and personal choices that allow them to flourish as health professionals and as people. Dr. Wagner's award will be presented by way of a video by Dr. Alessandra Ferrario. And through this video recording, Dr. Ferrario is a research fellow in population medicine at Harvard's Pilgrim Healthcare. And following this, there will also be a video acceptance of that award by Dr. Wagner.
From Salamanca to Tampere, Dr. Anita Katharina Wagner has built bridges across cultures, organizations, and disciplines. Anita established the role of the health insurer in medicine's use in countries rolling out universal health insurance programs, leading to the field of research of medicines and health systems and numerous mentees. Anita, you have allowed us not only to become better researchers and more successful in our careers, but more importantly, to become better persons. And you've done that with wisdom, care, and selflessness. Thank you for your gifts of mentorship. Congratulations on this most well-deserved recognition.
Good afternoon, and greetings from Finland, and congratulations to all nominees and awardees. It takes caring and effort to nominate a colleague for an HMS Mentoring Excellence Award. I thank you, Alessandra, and the other colleagues who nominated me and who reviewed the nominations. And thank you, Alessandra, both for recording a video, just in case you couldn't make a Zoom connection work, from Somalia, and I see that you actually do make it work, you're online. So thank you so much. I'm humbled, honored, and grateful to be recognized in the name of Dr. Barger for the part of the work I treasure most. Being helpful on the journeys of the dedicated, thoughtful mentees I'm fortunate to work with is the most meaningful and rewarding responsibility I have. It allows me to seek to listen carefully, to create space for trustworthy relationships, and to learn, grow, and strive together to make the world a better place. From my perspective, this is the essence of life. The award celebrates the value of mentoring that characterizes the Department of Population Medicine and the dedicated mentors there who continue to guide me, foremost Silen awardee, Dr. Dennis Rostegnan. Seeking to pass on the mentoring gifts I'm receiving is the one way for me to thank my mentors par excellence at HMS and across the world. I'm enormously grateful to each of you. Thank you. Kitos balion, as I have learned to say here.
Thank you, Anita. Please join me in congratulating all of the Barger recipients. Dr. William Silen set a model of excellence during his many years at Beth Israel Hospital and Harvard Medical School by example of his work as an educator, mentor, clinician, researcher, and academician. This included being a didactic instructor, a nurturer, a seeker of talent, an upholder of impeccable standards, a tough taskmaster when necessary, a compassionate listener, and a dedicated and patient teacher. Dr. Silen was appointed the first dean of diversity at Harvard Medical School, and in 1995, thankfully, was very excited and supportive when I approached him about wanting to establish what would become the first of Harvard Medical School's Excellence in Mentoring Awards. Although,
in the half theater and then
turn off sound. Although he's retired from Harvard Medical School, once a teacher and a mentor, always a teacher and a mentor. I'm honored to present the 2022 William Silen Lifetime Achievement and Mentoring Award recipients. And again, I'm going to ask the presenter to come to the podium as I announce the awardee, the picture, and then we'll move forward with that. The first recipient of the Silen Award is Dr. Marcello De Carli, the Seltzer Family Professor of Radiology at Brigham and Women's Hospital. I first met Dr. De Carli while rotating through the clinical nuclear service. I had little experience in clinical research and had not seriously considered a physician-scientist path. I shared with him my strong commitment to improving cardiovascular health for women, and he quickly identified an investigative spirit within me that I did not even know existed. I'm thrilled to report that I'm now pursuing a clinician-investigator career focused on elucidating biological sex differences that contribute to CVD. This would not be possible without Dr. De Carli's support. I owe my career to him, and he inspires me as a teacher, mentor, and role model. Dr. De Carli has mentored hundreds of trainees in his exceptional career, many of whom are now leaders in academic medicine, industry, and healthcare. Dr. De Carli epitomizes the consummate mentor, selfless, passionate, and driven. He possesses one of the most essential features of a remarkable mentor, the capacity to share generously of his time. Dr. De Carli's award will be presented by Dr. Ron Blackstein, Professor of Medicine, Brigham and Women's. Dr. Blackstein.
"21 years ago, Marcello De Carli, now the Seltzer Family Professor of Radiology and Professor of Medicine at Harvard Medical School, arrived at Brigham and Women's Hospital to head a small nuclear cardiology section. His career over that time has been nothing but remarkable. He has emerged as an international expert in cardiovascular imaging, a pioneer in the use of cardiac PET to diagnose blood flow and inflammation. He established a top cardiovascular imaging program in the country, editor of multiple journals. And that all would have been a remarkable career. But of all those things, what Marcello values the most is mentoring others. He has made mentoring his top priority. Whether clinical fellows who come from all over the world to train in his program or research fellows, through the NIH-funded program that he has established, they all come to train with Marcello De Carli. I consider myself very fortunate that I came to Brigham 15 years ago as an instructor and made it through the ranks to professor under and because of the mentorship of Marcella DeCarli. But I am not unique at all. We now have three full-time professors in our program, all emerged in that role because of Marcello. Marcello is a mentor's mentor. We often in medicine talk about a doctor's doctor, the person that people go to, other doctors, to get advice. He's the one that other mentors go to get advice. And the reason for that is he sets the gold standard for what mentorship is. What makes him so successful? Five things. He has enthusiasm, wisdom, and passion to make research fun, but also to help mentees select good research questions, one that they can tackle. They may not realize at the time that they can tackle it, but he knows, because he knows how to select the talent and he knows how to motivate others. Number two, he's a very hard worker and he leads by example, and you need to do that as a leader. He advocates for his mentees. He opens doors that others would never thought would be open to them. He provides honest feedback and he takes the time to really understand what is the specific needs that a mentee has. But above all, he truly cares about the success of his mentees. He is a selfless individual who not only cares about their academic success, but he cares about them as individuals, about their family. And at times, the time that you really know that someone cares is not when things are great and when there's awards and you get your paper published, but when things are not good, if there is a rejection, if there's a family issue going on. And Marcello is the first person to always help people out in times of need. On behalf of the over 100 mentees that you have mentored in the last two decades, it is the honor of a lifetime for me to be able to present you the award. We have many in the room here who are also mentees of Marcello DeCarli. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ron. That was totally undeserved, but I'm very grateful. And I'm deeply honored by this award. I was totally unexpected. When I got the call, they said from the office, it's a time-sensitive call from Dr. Reed. And I was really trying to figure out what went wrong. And so when I received the call, I was first stunned and shocked because this was kept from me. So I'm deeply grateful for all my mentees, all the people that nominated for this, and of course, to the selection committee. I think I have several day jobs, and by far the most rewarding part of my week is the day I dedicated to meet with all my trainees and the time I spent with all the faculty with whom I serve as their mentor. This is by far the best time because, you know, I really get to learn from them. I really get to be pushed to think about things that perhaps one might think at first glance that is not possible. It's a time where we develop friendships, and I'm deeply grateful for that time. So of course, I spend nights and weekends like many of the other mentors, and none of that would be possible without the infinite patience from my wife, who's here, Maria, and my daughters who are online. And I'm grateful for their support, for their constant inspiration to help others. And I'm so thankful for this award. Thank you.
Congratulations, Marcello. Next recipient of the Silen Award is Professor Ted Kapchuk, Professor of Global Health and Social Medicine at Harvard Medical School and Professor of Medicine at Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center. Quote, despite his own robust research portfolio and many responsibilities, Ted has also always made me feel like mentoring me was a priority. I spent many afternoons working through issues in his home garden, known as Ted's other office. He embodies compassionate wisdom and presence that goes far beyond academic knowledge, sometimes akin to a religious scholar or shaman. He has an ability to break down challenging situations into manageable, smaller issues with clear advice on incremental steps to work through them. Lessons learned from working through problems with Ted's guidance have greatly shaped my own mentoring and leadership practices. A few years ago, I had the realization that the best way to thank Ted for all his support was to pay it forward and to try to be as good a mentor as I can be to my students, fellows, and peers. Professor Kapchick's award will be presented by Dr. Sarah Ballou, Assistant Professor of Medicine, Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center. Dr. Ballou.
It is an honor to represent Professor Ted Kapchick's mentees today as he receives this award. Ted is a brilliant and dynamic researcher with internationally recognized expertise in placebo studies and East Asian medicine. He also has a profound understanding of clinical science, social sciences, and the humanities, which he weaves into his scientific work in a way that I can only describe as inspiring. What distinguishes Ted's mentorship, however, is not the impressive depth and breadth of his scholarly pursuits, but rather the generosity and enthusiasm that he brings to the role of mentor. Ted leans into mentoring so naturally that I've often wondered whether he even knows that what he's doing is so special. He recognizes and delights in his students' potential, many times before they've even recognized it in themselves. Ted inspires confidence, but he teaches humility and respect by example. Surely his mentees are all better researchers because of Ted, but I'd venture to say that we are also better colleagues and mentors ourselves because of him. Ted, you are cherished and admired by mentees all around the world. To be mentored by you is an absolute privilege. Congratulations.
We're here today to honor the mentors at Harvard Medical School and congratulate all the mentors. And one thing I wanted to say is that mentoring is underappreciated in our society. It's actually the key institution for transmitting the scientific and cultural DNA of producing new scientific and medical knowledge. Without the mentorship of my mentors, I could not have figured out how to turn textbook stuff into new knowledge. I'm honored with my, with the time I've mentioned the names of my mentors, but I see them in, I see myself when I work with people who are called my mentees, and I honor them by doing that. And I want to say that I couldn't be who I was without my trainees, and I see them replicating what I do and the baton of knowledge and hope to provide new medical care is going in them, and that will be transmitted to their trainees. And I want to thank them so much. I want to thank my colleagues, some are here, many are online, Dr. Lembo and Dr. Kelly, who I wouldn't be able to mentor without. And I wanted to thank, very importantly, my wife, Betsy Kapchick, who allows me to bring all these great people into her home. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Ted. The next recipient of the Silen Award is Dr. Ellen Seeley, Professor of Medicine, Brigham and Women's Hospital. Quote, as a Black female first-generation college student, Ellen affirmed my sense of belonging in the field of medicine and enhanced my visibility to admissions committees throughout the application cycle. She consistently provided me with clear, timely, and direct feedback about how to improve as a professional, including how to navigate work-life balance, ask for help, and delegate work to other members of the team. She cultivated my capacity for leadership and also models exemplary leadership to our team. During my white coat ceremony, the keynote speaker mentioned to me that, quote, Ellen is the prototype of what it means to be a woman in medicine. What an honor that must have been to work with her, end quote. It's an honor I could never truly articulate. She's been a constant source of support as I've progressed in my training, and she continues to be the most important, prominent role model I have in my life. Dr. Steele's award will be presented by Dr. Stephanie Mueller, Assistant Professor of Medicine, Brigham and Women's Hospital.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much. It's a true honor to be presenting this award to Dr. Steele on behalf of all of her mentees. I've had the great fortune of working with Ellen over the past, I think, 4 to 5 years now. And I've had the honor of working with her in this faculty development role in the Department of Medicine at Brigham and Women's Hospital. And I could go on and on about all the mentorship and the love of mentorship that Ellen brings to that kind of professional role that she has and how that bleeds into her mentorship of me within this faculty development role. But I think even more importantly is the sort of widespread devotion that she has to her personal mentoring relationships. As you can imagine, as the vice chair for faculty development, Ellen's schedule is incredibly busy and packed to the brim. And I have never once seen her turn away one meeting for related to mentorship or related to some faculty member that needs some career advice or some personal advice. And this is true for me as well. We have weekly meetings related to our faculty development work. And I've often sought her mentorship advice, and she intentionally schedules a separate meeting so that we can devote that entire time to her providing me that mentorship and that advice. I think the other thing that I have found just so special about Ellen is her role model as a successful academic woman in medicine who's successfully raised a family and is helping with childcare of her grandchild now. And I think especially as I sort of enter my mid-career in my own position where I'm busy with kids and with my own sort of career development, it's really nice to see that light. There's not that many women in her position who've been this successful, and it's just been such a great experience to have that role model in my life. So congratulations, Ellen. This is very well deserved.
So thank you all. I want to give a special thank you to, obviously, to my mentees. One of the most fun things was that a lot of my mentees couldn't be here. That wasn't the fun part, but I received all these texts over the past hour from mentees from all around the country, and reading the texts was really fun and a reaffirmment of what is so rewarding about being a mentor. I wanna first thank many of, beyond the mentees, thank the mentors who have, many of whom showed me ways to mentor, and I took pieces from different people. I want to mention Ron Arkey, who's in the room today as one of my mentors. The other ones are not physically here today. I also wanted to challenge the paradigm that mentoring is a selfless job that we do to help the mentee achieve career success. I think the most successful mentoring relationships are ones that are reciprocal, where there's even equal gain from the mentor and from the mentee. I know for myself that my career has been incredibly advanced by my mentees. My mentees have helped me finish writing papers that, if on my own, would drop to the bottom of a list. They've helped me get funding. And I think most importantly, they've helped make the work fun. And to work as hard as we work in this environment and to know that we can have fun doing our work makes the work, I think, feel all the more valuable and makes the hours we spend in them all the more valuable. The advice I give mentees, I get to listen to myself And when I talk to my mentees about work-life balance, my work-life balance is much better for at least 2 weeks. So, and then I get to learn from my mentees as they have progressed in their careers. My mentees now are PIs on grants that I am co-I on, which is a wonderful position to be in. They're often my teachers, and importantly, some of them have become my closest friends. One of the most rewarding parts of being a mentor, I think, is seeing your mentees become mentors themselves and seeing them be mentors successfully. And I'll mention Steph because she just won a mentor award herself. But many of my mentees have gone on to become incredibly successful mentors and have been supportive to me and shared their mentoring with me. And I want to just mention peer mentors briefly. We underestimate often the value of our peers in this rich environment that we work in, not only as source of really good ideas for the research we're doing, but for the support that they provide us. And I have a group of women endocrinologists, peer mentors. We've been together for about 20 years and they know who they are. And I want to give an acknowledgement to them. And the last, I want to acknowledge my family, including my new grandchildren, with whom I get to babysit, and thank my family as well for all the support. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ellen. Our final recipient of the William Silen Award is Dr. Linda Zahn, HMS Faculty of Arts and Sciences, Professor of Stem Cell and Regenerative Biology, and the Gruspeck Professor of Pediatrics at Boston Children's Hospital. Quote, I was recruited in 2009 to the Boston Children's Stem Cell Program, which Lynn directs. It was absolutely clear from the very get-go that Lynn was completely invested in my personal and academic success. He's been without a doubt the most important role model and most influential mentor in my scientific career. Lynn has mentored more than 60 postdoc or graduate students in his lab, and judging from his CV, at least 30 or so are independent investigators or clinicians in academic institutions around the world. Many of these are leading scientists, with many more on the way. Lynn's scientific progeny, besides being very successful, have played a key role in establishing the zebrafish as a widely accepted animal model to study multiple aspects of hematology and cancer biology. This would not have been possible without Lynn's continuous support, generosity, and activism. I'm honored to count myself among one of his mentees. Dr. Zahn's award will be presented by Dr. Carla Kim, Professor of Genetics, Harvard Medical School, Boston Children's Hospital. Drs. Zahn and Kim will join us by Zoom.
Good afternoon, can you hear me?
Yes.
Thank you. I am very happy to introduce Dr. Leonard Zahn as the recipient of this well-deserved award. As the chair of the stem cell program here at Boston Children's Hospital for the last 16 years, Len has been a phenomenal mentor to me and my colleagues. Despite having a busy lab and a successful research career with many graduate students, postdocs, and staff, Len has always made time for me and other faculty. Before I really knew Len, I thought he was a bit too enthusiastic, but never been hesitant to give us real, honest feedback. Len has taught us how to run a lab, rallied for opportunities for us, showed us how to create competitive Halloween videos, and led an example of how to create a supportive niche. When my daughter was born with severe medical complications, I knew that I had Len to count on for my continued sustainability as a faculty member. And thanks to him, today I'm a full professor. I feel very fortunate to have Len as a mentor. When I tell my colleagues who started their labs at the same time about everything Len has done for me and my colleagues, They are truly jealous. So congratulations, Ben, and thank you.
Well, thank you, Carla. Really a pleasure. I hope everybody can hear me. I'm really proud and happy to be a recipient of this year's HMS William Silen Mentor Award. It's been a great honor to be recognized by the people that you've trained or mentored, and it's been an absolute pleasure to watch their careers blossom. As a medical student, as a fellow, I had amazing mentoring. I saw how my mentors could go to bat for me. Alan Erslev and Jaime Caro at Jefferson Medical College initiated my lab experience and sent me off to Boston to train as a resident. I met Dre Groupman as an intern, and we worked together on the effects of HIV and hematopoiesis. And when I wanted to go to Stu Orkin's lab as a postdoc and couldn't get through Stu's administrator to get an interview, it was Jerry, who was riding on Route 9 in Boston, and pulled Stu over on the curb and to tell him that he should take me in the lab. So Stu taught me how to do great science the right way and became a lifelong friend. Sam Lux, also a recipient of an HMS Mentor Award, was my chairman and helped me with endless hours of meetings. He taught me to see the best in people. And David Nathan always gave me sage advice. My mentors instilled in me the philosophy that mentoring is a lifelong commitment and very rewarding and very fun. As my lab matured, I developed my mentoring approach. I worked with every person as an individual. I developed a number of mentoring lectures to provide advice about running a lab and being in a company or just how to tackle life. And these became two-hour events with different groups in the lab. We call them postdoc tea or graduate student lunch or technician breakfast. I even developed a game called You Be the PI that presented real lab situations and allowed us to discuss the approaches. So I took mentoring very seriously. And again, nothing was more satisfying than to watch your mentees or trainees become a professor or take a leadership role in a company, or even some of my mentees have gotten lifetime achievement awards already. It's really great. I always feel that joining the Zahn Lab was joining a family, but when I became the director of the stem cell program at Boston Children's Hospital, I really was able to hire and mentor faculty. And I really think I've been the luckiest to have the greatest faculty in the world. And it's just been an amazing pleasure to mentor them. And I'm so proud of their accomplishments, including Carla's, and to watch them all get promoted. I have one mentee that I'm most proud of. I was able to mentor George Daly. It's been a tough case, but I think it's gone pretty well. I want to thank all my mentees for proposing me as a candidate for this. My real family is here, and I wanted to thank my children, Becky and Tyler, for being such great individuals, and I'm so proud of your accomplishments. I want to thank my wife, Linda, for putting up with me, trying to actually mentor her or the family. I acknowledge that doesn't always go so well. But I'm very happy to accept the HMS Mentor Award, and I will always treasure it. So thank you very much.
So thank Lynn, but if we could have a thank you for all of our Silen awards. Stories we've heard today testify to the importance of good mentoring, to the extraordinary commitment and dedication of our faculty, and to the difference these faculty members have made in the lives of others. The stories are a testament to the fact that we really are better together as mentors, mentees, faculty, trainees, and students. This underscores the importance of acknowledging and celebrating what we can accomplish together. I want to thank Dean Daly for his commitment to advancing mentoring and faculty development, both of which are underscored within our HMS Better Together plan. Mentors, thank you for seeing the possibilities within your mentees. Thank you for showing them how to see beyond the now and for providing the tools for them to envision the greater. We're going to be asking those who are on Zoom to turn on your cameras, so that you can do the Zoom group photograph, and for the recipients to come to the front for a group photograph with your awards. Ellen, I have you. I also want to extend a thank you to all of the family members for releasing your loved ones to give their time to mentor. We heard that as a recurring theme. To the nominators for this year's awards, to the selection committee for your time and commitment to the program, to the DICP staff for coordinating this process. Teresa, in this hybrid environment, just an excellent job in putting this program together. And to each of you for joining us to honor our 2022 Excellent in Mentoring Award recipients. Thank you. Awardees could come to the front and please join us in the Courtyard Cafe for refreshments. Thank you.